De Trevor, Ben Furman, and the God usually bought something from the fishman later and went and sat in pastures. The fishman later always came home on this train. Turn past River slowly today for Peter Sam. He thought this could make him late. Much late. At last, his Trevor and Furman came. Hurry up, please. He whistled to the passengers, and they came trembling back to the station. Peter Sam sizzled, was sizzling with impatience. How awful, he thought, if it Miss Henry's train. The last passengers arrived. The guard was ready with his flag and whistle. The fisherman later walked across the platform. Then it happened. The guard says that Peter Sam was too impatient. And Peter Sam says he was ever he had a whistle. Anyway, he started. Come quickly, it puffed. Stop, 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 one of the coaches. You've left her behind, you've left her behind. The guard whistled and waved its red flag. The driver, looking back, saw the refreshment lighter, shouting and running after the train. This made Peter Sam feel ever cross and even more ever impatient. Bother, it crooned. As it stopped, will Miss Henry know? The fishman later climbed into Patras and they started again. We're sure it's a bit late. Peter said frantically. Is Trevor? And to keep checking him, steady, higher, steady. Peter Sam whistled at the stations. Hurry, please, hurry. And they reached the big station, just as Henry came in. As they went there, Peter Sam continued his song. Underground, overground, wambling fear. The wombles of Wimbledon common are we, making good news to the things that we find. Things that their everyday perks it behind. Uncle Pilgeria, we can remember the day when it wasn't behind the tubes. There's map of the world. Pick up the papers and take them to Oats. I'm not ever good at playing, singing some old song. That singing's not ever good. It's him not ever good at all. It's him just ever good at narrating. Peter Sam just loves that song. It suits him just ever well. Well, indeed. Just ever favourite. Hurrah, said Peter Sam. We've caught him after all. And let off. Steve with the left. Whoosh! Not bad, youngster, said Henry loftily. So Peter Sam looks a bit nervous when the fisherman lady came to him. She was looking over cross, shaking a fist at him. What do you mean? You're leaving me behind, she demanded. And hele somber assessment letter. As he described about our passengers, it had told her what Henry had said. The fishman lighter laughed. "You silly engine," she said. "Henry wouldn't dare cope. It's got white. It's a Cuban chain connection." "Well," said Peterson. "Well, where's that, Henry?" But Peter Sam was too late at time for Henry had sorted away. "January Fool's Day," said Henry. Peter Sam was ever annoyed. "Come back, and this end of this story. Told him